And good evening, everybody, and welcome here to our second race of the season of the NNSCRA Oreo Truck Series. Tonight, we're getting ready for an exciting race at the dirt track of Eldora, the 1-800 Car Cash Midsummer Classic. Now, this is going to be a very interesting race for these drivers, and basically for me as well, because it's the first time that I've ever had these cars or had any NNSCRA race run at Eldora. And here tonight, we're going to have two qualifying races, where we're going to have a total of 36 drivers at the end of the night battling it out for the win. That means that a total of 6 drivers will be missing out on the Midsummer Classic, and those drivers are the drivers that in both of these two qualifying races finish in positions, I think it's going to be in 19th, 20th, and 21st. They will not take part in the main event here tonight. So on the poll for our first qualifying race is going to be Levi McIntyre, and he'll start alongside of Joe Davis. McIntyre, 3 weeks ago at Daytona, finished in the 30th position, and Joe Davis in the 4 ended up finishing in 14th. They come in those spots in the standings respectively. George Roque will start off this evening in the 3rd position, as he comes in 32nd in the point standings, and John Cittadino, who finished in 20th last week, he will roll off from 4th. Completing the top 5 is going to be Mason Wood, and he was 26th in the Daytona race 3 weeks ago. Time to get these trucks rolling off, though, and we're going to get ready to turn them loose here. I have actually turned off, I believe, where the dirt will fly up. That way I'm actually able to see these trucks, because before I could not see them with the dirt screen. There is going to be some dirt, but it hopefully won't be a lot flying up that you won't be able to make out who is running where. As you take a look on the top of your screen, showing you the drivers that are taking part in this segment. As the pace car peels off, here we go. Green flag is out. 30 laps of racing. At the end of these 30 laps, we will know what 18 drivers from this segment will move into the main event of the Midsummer Classic. We got George Roque getting a nice run down there. Going to go try and go 3 wide underneath McIntyre and Joe Davis. John Cittadino got a good run too as he tried going through the middle. Visibility going to be a big problem for these drivers here tonight with, as you can see, that dust cloud kicked up there. McIntyre now up and into the wall. Oh, comes right down in front of, I believe that might have been Jessica Shelton, and they almost wrecked. Mason Wood now gets a big run to the inside. Still 3 wide for the lead. This time it's the 8 coming to the bottom. He and Joe Davis going to go by George Roque. Roque caught on the high side. Dylan Thoreau just got turned. Dylan Thoreau just got turned in the middle of the pack. Is that enough for a caution flag, though? I don't know, as here comes Trent Dunham 3 wide underneath George Roque and Joe Davis. Justin Talapa's coming as well, and I don't think the caution's out. These drivers are not slowing down. So let's quickly jump back to Dylan Thoreau and see if he was able to hang on to her. Looks like it. It looks like he and Caleb Farrell have both got some damage on their machines. Look at that dust cloud. Take a look at this onboard with Dylan Thoreau and see just exactly how the visibility is here. How do they even know where they're going? I don't know how they know where they're going. That just does not make sense to me, but they're figuring it out somehow. Right now, Michael Norman would be one driver who would miss out on the Midsummer Classic main event, as he's running 19th. Eric and Rage is in 20th, and Bob Jones in 21st. So those drivers have got to get going here. They finish in those spots. Those 3 will not make the Midsummer Classic, as George Roque is now back to the lead. Whoa, Joe Davis got wicked loose off that corner, as here comes Trent Dunham down to the inside, 3 wide for second. Justin Talampas right behind this battle here as well. Rookies, 3 veterans up here in the top 6, as they almost went 4 wide there. Talampas thought about it. Thinks better of it. Oh, Andreas Allen has spun. And that, I think, is a caution. Andreas Allen has spun his machine. Also, a couple of other drivers on pit road. I saw Steven Pollard, the 3rd, on pit road. And just ahead of him, I believe that's Alex Pedro in the 7. So that is going to bring out our first caution of the evening here on lap 11. There is Dylan Thoreau's machine. I think he still is on the lead lap. Bob Fergus has got damage on his 07. Don't rightly know where this started. I don't think there's any drivers, though, here on track that don't have some damage in one way or another. But nonetheless, caution flag is out, and George Roque is the current leader. Let's quickly jump back and take a look at a replay of what happened to Andreas Allen, Steven Pollard III, and Alex Pedro. Well, with all the dust being kicked up and everything, the helicopter view is the best way to see what happened. Oh, Sean Galligan's going to clip Jessica Shelton. She comes down to Steven Pollard III, who then comes up into Bob Fergus and Tanner Sullivan. And then Fergus and Pollard are going to spin around right in front of everybody. Pedro head-on into the 16, and then Andreas Allen is into the back of Alex Pedro. And Dylan Thoreau also getting involved there. Now, did Thoreau hit the back of Shelton? No. He got on the brakes to avoid this wreck, and he locked him up, and he slid up the hill. So, oh, and Chris Washer, what happened to him? Did he get turned by Caleb Thoreau? Oh, he tried sneaking by on the high side on Bob Fergus and got sideswiped on the left. So Chris Washer was collected in this as well. So Washer, Fergus, Allen, Pollard, Pedro, Shelton, and Dylan Thoreau all involved in this one. Now, I believe Andreas Allen actually has come off pit road. I think Alex Pedro may have done the same. That's not confirmed, though, until we come back to live action, which we're going to do now. But that's our first caution of the evening here. And look at there. There's Michael Norman and Eric and Rage, and you'll see Bob Jones in a minute. This is a big break for them. This gets them out on 19th, 20th, and 21st as far as the running order right now, and it may end up putting them into the main event of the Midsummer Classic. Well, we are just about halfway here. We'll go back to green on lap 15 of 30, giving us 16 laps to go. George Roque is the leader. John Cittadino in second. Third place is going to be Trent Dunham. Fourth place, Joe Davis, and Justin Talapa's fifth. Sixth, Mason Wood. Levi McIntyre, seventh. Eighth, Tanner Sullivan. Sean Galligan in ninth. And Matthew Dalio will complete the top 10. A couple of drivers lined up on the inside line, a lap down, at least. That is Dylan Thoreau, Bob Fergus, Alex Pedro, and Andreas Allen. Green flag back out. Only one driver is out of the race right now, and that is Steven Pollard III. So he will not take part in the Midsummer Classic main event. And what Alex Pedro and Andreas Allen have to hope is that we have another big wreck or something, so that way they can move up out of 19th and 20th, because being two laps down right now, they're in a very precarious position. George Roque is gone with the lead. Cittadino now moves into second. Battle is on for third. Joe Davis to the inside of former Truck Series champion Trent Dunham. And the pole sitter, Levi McIntyre, starting to work his way back towards the front now. Going underneath to the fifth position of Mason Wood as Cittadino slid up in that corner. And now it's three wide behind him. And I think someone may have just wrecked back here. They did. Matthew Dalio, Michael Norman, Tanner Sullivan. Oh, Bob Jones and Andreas Allen now slide up the hill. Dalio's got a lot of damage. Jessica Shelton's got a lot of damage. And Alex Pedro, I think, was collected again. That's going to be a caution flag as look out. The leader's now going by the damaged machine of Andreas Allen. Looks like they all get through it all right. And George Roque, who was running away with this thing, he's now kind of have it all bunched back up again. And this could be the break I was saying that Alex Pedro and Andreas Allen needed, because a number of those drivers, including Jessica Shelton and Matthew Dalio, looked like they had quite extensive damage on their machines. The caution flag is out once again with about 10 to go and we hit the stripe. Let's take a look at a replay of what just happened. And this caution is going to be caused by Tanner Sullivan and Dylan Thoreau. Watch the red car on the high side. Going to get clipped by the green car. And sent down there into Matthew Daly, who was running in the 10th position at the time. This happens right in front of Caleb Farrell as well. Nice job by Farrell to get on the brakes to avoid. Then Michael Norman comes in. He's going to hit Tanner Sullivan. There's Jessica Shelton, nowhere to go. Look at Eric and Rage sneak by on the very bottom of the racetrack. And there you see Chris Washer and Bob Jones held up. Washer does get a little piece of it. And then here comes Andreas Allen and the leaders on through as well. So close call here for the leaders and everybody, but looks like everybody was able to continue from this one too. So let's head back, see what the end result's going to be now. And we'll go back to Great Flag Racing on lap 24 of 30. This is only our first segment. We still got a second qualifying segment and then the main event of the Midsummer Classic here tonight at Eldora. We'll have a total of 7 laps to go when we go back to green. George Roque is the leader. Second place is Joe Davis. Third is Trent Dunham. Fourth, Levi McIntyre. Fifth, Mason Wood. John Cittadino, 6th. 7th, Justin Talampa. Sean Galligan, 8th. Eric and Rage in 9th. And Carib Farrell is in 10th. Those guys, I think we could basically say they are going to be in the main event. The green flag's back out, as I believe a couple of drivers have retired from this race. I'll try and update them in just a minute. We got to wait until some of those lap machines like Andreas Allen and Alex Pedro actually complete a couple laps so we know just exactly who is out of the race. And, oh, Matthew Dalio. I thought that was the pace car for a minute. Matthew Dalio coming off pit road. Roque now going to put Bob Jones down a lap. Levi McIntyre has now moved his way back up to second. And his teammate, Sean Galligan, right behind, cautions out. This race may end under yellow now because the caution flag is waving. And George Roque looks like he's going to win the first qualifying segment here tonight and ensure himself that he is going to be in the main event. And I saw Mason Wood and Justin Talampas coming down pit road. Right now, as things stand, according to how the standings look, Alex Pedro, Jessica Shelton, and Stephen Pollard III would be the three that miss out on the main event. But that's not exactly confirmed yet because we haven't finished this race. So let's quickly jump back, take a look at a replay, and then come back and see if this race is indeed going to end under the caution flag. Just a lot of hard racing at the front. A lot of these battles were for a position. Watch in the back there. John Cittadino going to turn Trent Dunham down to Justin Talampas. And then just as that happens, Mason Wood comes up into Joe Davis and Andreas Allen. I think he was trying to avoid the Matthew Dalio machine down there on the apron. Eric and Rage going to get a little piece of that. Look at Sean Galligan. Wow. He did a great job getting through that. Andreas Allen caught up behind Mason Wood there. There's Talampas' machine. Badly damaged. And there's Andreas Allen now just barely now getting around the spun out 8 machine of Mason Wood. But, yep, just like what we've seen all night long, a lot of drivers battling hard for position, and that slight bit of contact and the very huge lack of grip here with it being a dirt track just brings about these kind of wrecks. Let's head back now as the white flag, I believe, is about to come out. And indeed, the white flag will come out, but it will come out with the green flag as they will have a one-lap shootout to finish off this qualifying session here at Eldora. Now, George Roque right now in a good position because he's got Bob Jones, a lap machine between himself and Levi McIntyre. Keep in mind, though, the winners of these qualifying races do not get credited, though, with an NNSCRA victory because it is a non-points event. It is simply a qualifying race. But right now, George Roque going to try and maybe make a statement for when he heads over into the Midsummer Classic. As here we go, green flag, white flag displayed at the same time. Can George Roque make it around just one more time to win a race that he has dominated here tonight? They're having trouble with Bob Jones back there, our Levi McIntyre and John Cittadino. As George Roque crosses the line, Roque will win the first qualifying session and makes his way into the main event of the Midsummer Classic. And let's see who officially is going to miss out, and it's going to be Justin Talampas, who just recently took his car back behind the wall. He will miss the Midsummer Classic main event, so will Jessica Shelton and Stephen Pollard III. So a tough break for those three drivers. Talampas came in 6th in the point standings. This is really going to hurt him. Shelton came in 19th in points, and Stephen Pollard III came in 17th in points. Those three, boy, it's really going to hurt them that they're not going to be taking part in the main event. So what's going to happen is at the end of the Midsummer Classic, those three drivers will get credited with a default 5 points, which equals out to a 37th place finish due to the fact that there will be 36 drivers in the Midsummer Classic. So tough break for those drivers, though, but There are three other drivers that will not take part in the main event of the Midsummer Classic, and we're about to find them out in just a minute. Stay tuned. Here comes your full finishing results from this qualifying session. Let's head over now to our next qualifying session before our main event of the Midsummer Classic here tonight at Eldora. So as we get set now for our second qualifying race, we know that there are three drivers that will not take part in the Midsummer Classic. Justin Talampas, Jessica Shelton, and Stephen Pollard III. It'll be interesting to see here in this second segment what three drivers are going to miss out on the main event for the Midsummer Classic, as Kyle Matthews sits on the pole position for this evening's race. 39th in points he comes in, so nice spot for him to be able to try and make the Midsummer Classic. As alongside of him is going to be Chris Dollerton, who finished 9th 3 weeks ago at Daytona. Carson Gumm finished 10th at Daytona and will start off in 3rd. And Jake Rogers is going to start off in 4th. He was 31st at Daytona. And right out the top 5 is going to be Nick Smith, going to try and see if he can get one of the Retro Enterprises Chevys into the main event, as he finished last week at Daytona in the 25th position. Time to get these trucks rolling off. Again, it's going to be another 30-lap event, as they're going to take their positions here on track. And this one's going to be an interesting one, too, because there are a number of drivers up in the top 10 in points that are in this segment, including Dylan Pote, the points leader and winner 3 weeks ago at Daytona. Matthew Daly, 3rd in points. Zach Hamlin, 5th in the point standings. And as we said, Chris Dollerton and Carson Gumm starting up here at the front. They are 9th and 10th in the current points. 11th, 12th, and 13th in points. James McLeod, Charles Jackson, and Drew Austin are also in this field, as the green flag is out here for 30 laps. Let's see what 18 drivers here are going to make their way into the 36-car field in the main event tonight. Kyle Matthews got a good jump, but Carson Gumm, strong on that inside line, going to try and go for the point. And again, that visibility problem going to be really tough for these guys, as Kyle Matthews just got moved up by Chris Dollerton 3 wide. And here comes Jake Rogers down to the bottom. Oh, look out there, 4 wide! And Dylan Young almost got turned by Luke Walker. Holy cow, this is great. Nick Smith leading now, but here comes the 27 of Henry Sanford to the bottom. Finished dead last at Daytona last week. Oh, Carson Gumm and Jake Rogers have just spun around. That's going to be a caution, as here comes Cody Hagan to the bottom for the top position. Cody Hagan looking for the lead here under this caution flag. He will get it. And I believe Dollerton just barely got Sanford the line. Whoa, look out. Carson Gumm still stuck there on the apron, and he almost had himself collected up by the leaders, as there's Jake Rogers on the apron as well. A lot of front-end damage on his machine. He and Carson Gumm were the two I saw get together. I don't know if anybody else is involved. Daniel Voiles is involved. Zach Buchanan may have some damage. Dylan Pote's on pit road, and he's retired. That's the points leader. Voiles on pit road. Matthew Daly, 3rd in points, is on pit road. And who's that car behind him? That's Brandon Trasta. Or Crasta, I'm sorry, Brandon Crasta. I have to remember how to say that name. There is Carson Gumm and Jake Rogers on pit road. And the caution flag is out, and we know that Dylan Pote has just retired. And he may end up finishing dead last. The points leader may not even take part in the second race of the season here. Cody Hagan is the leader, though, under the yellow. Let's jump back and see what exactly happened. Well, here it was. Carson Gumm right up into the left rear quarter panel of the 91, who was up in the outside wall. And Rogers, after he finishes hitting the wall, he comes down. He's going to hit Carson Gumm and then spin out right in front of the field. Luke Walker going to get a tiny piece of that. There's where Matthew Daly gets involved. It's a stack up back there. Drew Austin and Dylan Poteet all involved there. And as these drivers, I think there was something else that happens further up involving the 24 of Voiles, because that didn't look like Voiles got that much damage from that incident. Let's look further up here. I think something's going to happen on the following lap, but I'm not rightly sure. Carson Gumm teleports to pit road. Oh, that was Brandon Crasta up ahead. Something happens with the 45. See here what exactly happens. Oh! Remember the Carson gum machine that was caught on the apron there? Well, Krasta's gonna be the one to hit him. Right here. Oh, man. Rips the whole front off of that 45 machine, and then as his car's gonna come sliding down the track, right behind him there you see them coming. Drew Austin gonna go high. Daniel Voiles pushes Dylan Pote practically into Brandon Krasta. And look who was right behind this. Kyle Matthews was right behind this wreck. Wow. That was a close call there for Kyle Matthews. But Dylan Pote, the points leader, our winner a couple weeks ago at Daytona, he's involved. There's Daniel Voiles. Heavy damage on his machine. We may already know the three drivers that are going to miss out the main event here. I don't know. Well, anyway, let's head back up to live action and see what exactly is going to happen now. Well, folks, we probably are going to go back to green in the next lap or so, but what we're going to do, and this is something pretty unusual, but it kind of will save time, we are going to head to about 5 laps remaining in this race because we know now the drivers already that are not going to be in the main event. So it doesn't really seem like much sense of broadcasting the entire race here, since this is merely a qualifying race, and those three drivers that will not be in the main event include the points leader and our winner from the last Truck Series race 3 weeks ago at Daytona. Dylan Pote will finish the evening in the 19th position. Then you've got Jake Rogers, former Truck Series champion in his own right. He's going to finish 20th tonight. He will not be in the main event, and neither will Carson Gum, who came in 5th in rookie points and inside the top 10 in points as well. Those three will join Jessica Shelton, Justin Talampas, and Stephen Poehler III in the infield to watch out the remainder of this race. So don't go away. We'll be right back with about 5 laps remaining in this qualifying session. Well, welcome back. We are going to have a total of 6 to go when we hit the stripe here, working yet another caution flag. James McLeod is on the tail end of the lead lap. Cody Hagan is actually the leader. Green flag back out. Henry Sanford second, Dollerton third, Nick Smith is fourth, fifth is Luke Walker, sixth Drew Austin, seventh Charles Jackson, eighth Dylan Young, ninth LJ Mills, and Zach Buchanan completes the top 10. Cody Hagan coming to the bottom on James McLeod. That's for the lead. I think I said there was five to go. There's actually 15 to go. And we do have a couple more drivers back behind the wall, too. Kyle Matthews has gone behind the wall, and so has Zach Hamlin. Matthew Daly, I believe, is still running, as is James McLeod. Chris Dalton going to the bottom for the lead off of Henry Sanford. All these drivers you see on track, including a number of drivers already out of the race, are going to be transferring into the main event of the Midsummer Classic. However, we do know now officially the 6 drivers that are going to miss racing in the 36th field in the main event. They include the points leader Dylan Pote, Carson Gum, Jake Rogers, Jessica Shelton, Justin Talampas, and Stephen Poehler III as Cody Hagan goes back to the point. He's been leading a majority of the evening. I don't think there's really been very much time that Cody Hagan has not been out in front. Nick Smith having a very good run too. He has not fallen outside of the top 5 all evening long. And Chris Dollerton back there having a great run, coming off his 9th place finish 3 weeks ago at Daytona, as they go 3 wide there with Dollerton, Henry Sanford, and the lap down machine of James McLeod. Number of drivers going to have to go to backup trucks, but they are going to take part in the main event regardless. Nick Smith goes to the point. Almost some contact there. There was some contact, actually. What am I saying almost for? Between Henry Sanford and James McLeod is right now Nick Smith trying to pick up what would be a non-points win, but still be great momentum for that 94 team. As whoa, James McLeod. Is he coming to pit road or something? Nope, they must have wrecked. Cody Lamas is on the apron. Drew Austin also is slow. And John Trollston is coming to pit road. I believe the caution flag is out. It is indeed. With about 5 laps to go, caution flag is waving. So apparently Trollston, Cody Lamas, and Drew Austin had something happen to them. Let's jump and see if we're going to have a restart to finish out this qualifying session now. And we will get back to green flag racing. It'll be on lap 29 of 30. Green white checker to finish off this one. It was a one lap shootout to finish off the first qualifying session. It'll be a green white checker to finish out the qualifying session here for the second segment. Nick Smith, Henry Samfer, Chris Dalton, Cody Hagen, and Luke Walker. That is the top five. Then it's Zach Buchanan, Charles Jackson, Dylan Young. I think these drivers are a lap down. I think that is it for the lead lap cars back through Dylan Young. Here we go. Green flag right back out. White flag will be next time around, and we'll see who's going to win this session. George Roque won the first qualifying session as Nick Smith right now leads the way. Henry Samfer right behind, though. Cody Hagen, I think he may have actually just pushed Henry Samfer on the inside line there. White flag displayed. Looks like no lap machines will come into play in this. Samfer going to go for the lead. He got the lead, but here comes the Cody Hagen machine for the bottom. Here they come out of the final corner. It's going to be a drag race. And I think, who was it? I can't even see through the smoke. Cody Hagen got Henry Samfer at the line. Wow. That was a photo finish. I didn't even get to see it because of that stupid dust cloud. Hold on a doggone minute. I want to see how close that was. See if we can get a camera angle here. Guess we're going to have to rely on our helicopter view. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Look at that. That was the finish of a qualifying session. Unbelievable. Cody Hagen by inches just barely beats out Henry Samfer. That's two rookies, too. In their very first starts on a dirt track in NNSCRA competition. Man, that was a great run right there. Too bad that wasn't the main event, but that was a great race right there. So, we know for certain the drivers that are going to be not taking part in the Midsummer Classic. I basically told them to you. I'll tell them to you one final time here. Dylan Poteet, Justin Talampa, Stephen Paul III, Jessica Shelton, Jake Rogers, and Carson Gum. All 36 other drivers will move into the main event, which we will head to now, right after we show you your full finishing results from this, our second qualifying session. And good evening, everybody. Welcome to the main event here at Eldora, getting ready for the 1-800 Car Cash Midsummer Classic at Eldora Speedway, our second race of the season. You were just watching the qualifying sessions to see what 36 drivers were going to make their way into tonight's 50-lap main event. And we already know that there are six drivers that are not going to be taking part in this evening's event, including our winner at Daytona and the guy who came in as the points leader, Dylan Poteet. So if you think that this race is going to shake up the points, you would be 100% correct. As Zach Buchanan sits on the pole for this evening's main event, Buchanan is 28th in points. He'll start alongside of Chris Dollerton, who finished top 5 in his qualifying session. He will roll off from 2nd and comes in 9th in the point stand. Sean Galligan finished 41st 3 weeks ago, I should say, at Daytona. He is going to roll off from 3rd. And our winner from our second qualifying session, Cody Hagen, who won in a photo finish against Henry Samfer, will start off the evening in 4th place. Take a look at the top of your screen as you will see the official starting lineup for this evening's event. Dylan Poteet came in as the points leader, Chris Washer 2nd, Matthew Daly 3rd, Bob Jones 4th, Zach Hamlin 5th, Justin Talampa 6th, 7th Alex Pedro, Matthew Dalio in 8th, 9th Chris Dollerton, and 10th Carson Gum. Three of those drivers will not be in tonight's main event, so it'll be interesting to see exactly what the points will look like after this evening's race, and who's going to pick up the win here in our very first ever race at Eldora Raceway in the Truck Series. 50 laps of racing, 36 drivers getting ready to turn them loose here. Green flag is out here at Eldora. Chris Dollerton tried to jump that start there, trying to get around Zach Buchanan on the high side, but the inside line is the line that moves, and Buchanan now going to utilize it as he will now take full control of the lead. Look at that dust cloud. How do these drivers even see where they're going? Sean Galligan now coming to the bottom. Best thing he could do to counter his 41st place finish 3 weeks ago at Daytona is to get a win. I can't even see. Well, they are still running. I thought they might have wrecked. But they are still running as Galligan leads, Buchanan into second, Matthews third, and I think the caution may actually be out. Yep, it is. Mason Woods on pit road, so is Dylan Young. And there's Henry Samfer. Looks like he's okay. It looks like it was Dylan Young, Mason Wood that got together. Caution flag is out. Let's head back and see what happened. First caution of the evening here in the Midsummer Classic at Eldora. Here's what happened, and Dylan Young in the Lucky Charms Toyota going to get more than a little help here from Levi McIntyre in the 22. Car's going to snap around on him, come right up, and Mason Wood had absolutely nowhere to go. It's a tough break there for Mason Wood. Tough break for Dylan Young, too, who was running in the 13th position at the time, just got flat-out turned there by the 22 machine. But that's what put us out of the caution. Whoa, somebody else had trouble back here? Oh, it was Bob Jones and Henry Samfer back here. Did they just get caught on the high side, or did they spin, too? Watching the 11 on the bottom left. Oh, they just slowed up to avoid the wreck. All right, so they're good to go. Oh, but Michael Norman got a piece of Dylan Young there. So the 3 car was involved as well. So caution flag's out. Let's head back now for the restart. So we'll go back to green flag racing. Sean Galligan is the leader. Zach Buchanan second. Dollarton third. Matthews in fourth. And fifth is Zach Hamlin. Joe Davis is in 6th, Nick Smith runs 7th, Cody Hagan 8th, Daniel Voyles 9th, and Matthew Dalio is going to complete the top 10. See if anybody's out of the race. Mason Wood is out of the race. Dylan Young, I don't know if he's taking his car behind the wall or not. Nope, he's going to line up on the inside line, one lap down. So only one driver out of the race so far, that being the 8 of Mason Wood. Green flag back out here. Sean Galligan going to get us back underway. Single file restart. We'll see if these drivers are going to be able to settle down a little bit, but Eldora's a dirt track. A dirt track not normally known for good, clean racing. Chris Dalton now going to the bottom of Zach Buchanan. That is for second. Folks, we're going to step aside for one quick commercial break, and then we'll come back and be with you all the way to the checkered flag. So we'll see you in just a minute. And we'll be right back here to the Midsummer Classic at Eldora Speedway. Welcome back here to the Midsummer Classic, the 1-800 Car Cash Midsummer Classic at Eldora Speedway, as we have a new leader, Chris Dollarton, out in front. Now he's about to get a challenge from Kyle Matthews. Meanwhile, up ahead, Michael Norman, who is on, I believe, the tail end of the lead lap, running in 35th place. He is actually, no, he is 2 laps down. And they are going to encounter him pretty quickly here, and this could be trouble for the rest of these drivers. It's now Sean Galligan goes to the bottom. Here comes Nick Smith, the only rookie up here inside the top 4 right now, as they almost went 4 wide. Oh, and now leaning on each other. They bounced off each other to Nick Smith and Chris Dollarton. As they're 3 wide for the lead, Michael Norman's Bass Pro Shops Chevy Silverado looming just ahead. Nick Smith now going to make the move, and he'll go to the point. Meanwhile, good battle shaping up back there for 5th. Zach Buchanan now to the inside of rookie Joe Davis in the 4. And I believe that's Eric and Rage in the 14 catching up there. No, that's not. That's Cody Hagan. 3 wide again. This time, Galligan to the bottom. Matthews in the middle. And Nick Smith on the high side. And look at Chris Dollarton thinking about going up the middle and taking the lead. He can't do it this time. And now they catch up now to the slower lap machine of Michael Norman. Hopefully they're going to be able to get past him without any problem. And oh boy, this is tight. This is really tight. Contact between Chris Dollarton and Nick Smith. They keep it together though. We're still green. We're still racing. And Galligan will take the top position. Chris Dollarton, former Truck Series champion, now battling for second with Nick Smith. Kyle Matthews, who was a 2-time winner in the trucks last season, trying to go to victory lane for the first time this season. Up ahead, another slower machine. That is John Cittadino in the 20. I believe he is the last car on the lead lap, and I believe he's now about to become the first car one lap down. Nick Smith going to make very short work at the Home Depot Toyota Tundra. He'll go by him. Kyle Matthews does the same. Meanwhile, Chris Dalton and Sean Galligan having their troubles with the lap machines of Michael Norman and John Cittadino, as now it's a two-truck breakaway at the front of the field. Well, I called Michael Norman a slower lap car. He is a lap car, but I don't think he's slower. He is still battling really hard there with Chris Dalton. Meanwhile, battle for the lead is on. Kyle Matthews going to the bottom on Nick Smith. Kyle Matthews trying to win his first race of the season. So too is Nick Smith. Oh boy, Chris Dalton got the wall off that corner. And now they're almost four wide here at Eldora with Cody Lamas, Daniel Voiles, and Joe Davis. How they made that work, I'm not exactly sure. But it has bunched everybody back up here from about the fifth position on back. Oh, don't try it again. Don't try it again. They are going to try it again. They're four wide at Eldora again. And they settle it out again to three wide racing. I don't understand how they're doing this. Oh, they're four wide back there again. That was Matthew Dalio. No, that wasn't Matthew Dalio. Who in the world was that? Was that Brandon Crasta? No, it wasn't Brandon Crasta. I don't know who that car was that was rim riding, but that was crazy. These drivers putting on one great show here tonight for the fans. And it took us two wreck-filled qualifying races to get to this. I can't believe that we've only been under the caution flag as many times as we have. And, well, as soon as I say that, there's another yellow. GG me. And, oh, whoa, 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 look out! Caleb Farrell there, and it was Dylan Thoreau parked in the middle of the track. Almost collected the leaders there. I also saw another car up scraping the wall, which looked like LJ Mills 42. Bob Jones appeared to be down on the apron, and now Michael Norman is down on the apron as well. Drew Austin apparently was collected in whatever this was, and Henry Samfer. Norman's coming to pit road. There's Drew Austin, there's Caleb Farrell, there's LJ Mills. And where's the 21 of Dylan Thoreau? I know I saw him. Oh, wow. Man, that car is crunched. As he currently sits on pit road. The leader, after all of this mayhem, is going to be rookie Nick Smith over Kyle Matthews, Sean Galligan, Chris Dalton, and Zach Buchanan. That is the top five. Let's look back at a replay of what puts under the caution once again here tonight at Eldora. And what a tough break for rookie Joe Davis. Was having such a good night. There you see in that four-wide situation, he gets up into the wall. That scrubs off a lot of his speed. And then heading down here into turn one, here comes a three-wide situation with George Roque, LJ Mills, and Chris Washer. And Mills just he takes the turn way too hard, slides up there into the four machine, and then continues to slide up into him. Finally, those cars are going to get turned around. Chris Washer held up behind this, is able to get to the inside. And then this is where everything just starts happening. Everybody trying to avoid. And this is where trouble's going to break out. Zach Hamlin going to get a piece of it right there. Here comes more traffic into view. And I have a feeling you're going to have a couple more drivers get collected in this one. Dylan Thoreau, I know, was one driver I saw involved. I also saw some damage on the Bob Jones machine. There is the hit that rips the whole front off of the Dylan Thoreau machine. And here comes Bob Jones. Heads into the back of the Joe Davis machine. Caleb Farrell right behind this. He's going to get a hit in the passenger side door. I don't know if he really got a whole lot of damage out of that, though. And then there's Drew Austin also getting a piece of it there in the 51. Can't tell. I believe that's Brandon Crasta gets through it, and so does Henry Samfer. So number of drivers do a good job getting through, but that is a tough break right there for Joe Davis and that four team. Ran top 10 all night long, and looks like their night comes to a very early end. Well, we'll go back to green flag racing with 20 laps remaining here tonight in the Midsummer Classic at Eldora. Rookie Nick Smith is currently the leader. Second, Kyle Matthews. Sean Galligan third. Fourth place is going to be Chris Dalton with Zach Buchanan in fifth. Daniel Voiles runs sixth. Seventh, Matthew Dalio. Eighth place is Cody Lamas. Cody Hagan up in ninth. And Charles Jackson is going to complete the top 10. Our two winners from our qualifying races, Cody Hagan and George Roque, are starting up inside the top 11. So watch out for those two as the green flag's back out. John Cittadino, one lap down, lines up on the inside line there. Drivers out of the race now after everything that you saw just happen include Brandon Krasta, Joe Davis, Dylan Thoreau, Bob Jones. Also out of the race are the cars of Dylan Young and also Michael Norman and Mason Wood. So right now, Nick Smith out in front, and he's actually starting to pull away a bit, which is one of the first times we've seen that take place here tonight at Eldora. Battle is raging up for second place at the current moment. Sean Galgan and Kyle Matthews, but those two almost kind of drafted here at Eldora. You never see that, but they kind of are. They're kind of drafting here, and they are going to get to the inside now of Nick Smith. Well, I thought they were. Smith's going to hold them off, at least for now. Oh, we got trouble. Levi McIntyre, Henry Sanford, and Tanner Sullivan coming up right in front of the field. Is there a caution, or are we still green? I can't see. That dust cloud covers over the flagman. It's a wonder these drivers can see the flagman. It's a wonder the spotters can see the flagman to let these guys know we're under caution. But apparently we are, because there's the pace truck. At least I can see that. So Sullivan, Sanford, and one other driver. I don't even remember who it was. Levi McIntyre. Apparently those three were the three to get together to put us under the caution once again. Caution's breeding cautions here late in the Midsummer Classic. Take a look at what happened. And this time another incident up near the front of the field, and it kind of was drivers trying to get around the slower machine of John Cittadino. Charles Jackson is going to hook Cody Hagan in the left rear, and when they both come back up track, it's a 5-wide situation. We've seen them be able to work 4-wide, but they can't do 5-wide. Cody Hagan actually lost it when he slid up in front of them, and there you see them involved there. John Trollston in the 29, Luke Walker gets pancaked up there. George Roque gets turned down into Alex Pedro. Eric and Rach again goes to the apron to avoid a wreck. Matthew Daly goes around on the high side there. LJ Mills comes in, plows into the back of Tanner Sullivan, and here comes Henry Sanford sliding in. He's going to get into the side of the 22 of Levi McIntyre. So that just came down to the fact that 5-wide's not going to work, and it was basically the machine of Cody Hagan. When he brought it back up into the turn, being dirt, there's no grip really, and he lost and came up in front of traffic, and that's what caused this problem. That's a tough break there for a number of these drivers too, who are running up just inside the top 10 or just outside the top 10 looking for a good night tonight, including Charles Jackson and Cody Hagan. But it seems to be typical Eldora here tonight, as we'll head back now for the restart. So we'll restart with 13 laps to go here tonight in the Midsummer Classic at Eldora Raceway. It's almost looking like this track really is good, and we may come back here next year. But right now, things are looking like they may not end under green. We had a long green flag run there for a moment, but now we've been having caution flags back to back. So I don't know, these drivers may get even racier here, knowing that the race could possibly end under the yellow flag. Nick Smith leads, Galligan second, Kyle Matthews third, fourth Zach Buchanan, and fifth place, I believe, is Chris Dollerton. And I don't think I was right on that. Anyway, I gotta quickly take this phone call, I'll be right back. I apologize for that, but it was a phone call I had to take. Anyway, the car that I actually mistaken as being Chris Dollerton running in fifth is actually Daniel Boyles running in fifth place. And now he's actually going for fourth under Buchanan. Someone just got turned in the middle of the field. I don't even know who it was. I couldn't even see it. But someone got turned right in the middle of the field, and that could be big, big trouble. I'm going to keep an eye on the leaders here because they may come up here on whatever that was if they haven't cleared away that wreckage yet. Oh, there they are. George Roque was one of them. Eric and Rage could have very well been another. Drew Austin there in the 51 as these drivers try and maneuver their way through. There's James McLeod up ahead, Matthew Daly. I don't know if they were involved or not, but whatever the case, something happened. And there is George Roque's machine. He had to have obviously been a big part of it. And I think they're hitting each other again. Sounded like someone ran into the back of somebody. Zach Hamlin's got more damage, so too does LJ Mills. And the caution flag is out once again, so it is looking more like this race is going to end under yellow. We're probably going to have somewhere about 4 or 5 laps to go when we get back green. We will get back green, that I'm certain of. But caution flag's out, and these cautions are the best friend right now of rookie Nick Smith, trying to get Retro Enterprise to victory lane for the first time this season. He leads the way. Let's take a look at what put us under the caution one more time. And the car that got spun that I was not able to see was John Cittadino once again, this time going to get turned off the nose of Levi McIntyre. Sent up into the wall, Chris Washer. Man, Washer seems to be in the wrong place at the wrong time all night long. He always seems to be just behind the spinning car. There's George Roque going to get a piece of it, and then everybody starts to pile in. Matthew Daly, James McLeod, Drew Austin, they all come piling into this here. Can't really blame them, though, with the visibility problems that we see these drivers have had. Andreas Allen was able to get around on the high side, though. But that is what put us under the caution, and the leaders came up on these guys pretty quickly, and we almost had our leaders wreck when these guys had a little bit of difficulty leaving the scene of the accident. But caution flag waves once again. Let's see what we're going to have to finish out this evening's race. So, according to what we have right now, we will have 5 laps to finish out tonight's race at Eldora. It will be a single-file restart due to the fact there are less than 10 laps to go, which hopefully will mean we could possibly end this thing under the green flag. However, if the caution comes out at any point between now and the end of the race, I'm pretty certain the race will end under caution. I don't think there's a way we can get back to green before the race ends. Nick Smith leads, Kyle Matthews second, third is Sean Galligan, Daniel Voyles now in fourth, and Zach Buchanan is fifth as we're back green. The rest of the top 10 are Matthew Dalio, Chris Dollerton. Bob Fergus is in 9th, and 10th is Cody Hagan. Wait, who's in 8th? Oh, Cody Lamas. Meanwhile, battle for the lead. Kyle Matthews down to the bottom of the racetrack. On Nick Smith, and here's Sean Galligan right there as well. Looking towards the flagman. I don't see a yellow. Or is there a yellow? Yes, there must have been a yellow, because there was a car up on its side. That's got to be a caution. And this race may be over. Kyle Matthews was the leader. Drew Austin on the apron again. Apparently something happened with him. There was one car over and on its side. I couldn't tell who it was. It was a white machine, though, I believe. But I believe Kyle Matthews is going to win this thing. And Chris Dollerton, who's been running the top 10 all night tonight, he's had troubles now. He's on the apron, badly damaged. It might have been him upside down. I don't know. What I do know is this race is going to end, and it will end under caution, and barring any problems, Kyle Matthews is going to be the leader and the winner of this evening's race. Chris Washer, second in points, badly damaged on pit road. I don't even think we need to look back at what happened, because whatever it was, it's ended out this race. And Kyle Matthews is the leader. Sean Galligan in second. I believe in third is Nick Smith. From there on back, though, I am not exactly certain what the running order is, because if Chris Dollerton was involved in something, it may have collected drivers inside the tail end of the top 10. Looks like Daniel Voyles, he is in fourth, and Zach Buchanan is going to complete the top 5 as they come out of 4 for the final time under caution. Kyle Matthews goes to victory lane for the first time in Season 8. It's his third career Truck Series victory. And what a win for Kyle Matthews here tonight. One of the 4 top drivers of the evening. It was basically going to be either him, Galligan, Nick Smith, or Chris Dollerton, I do believe, because those were the guys that basically were up front all night long. But Kyle Matthews capitalizes here tonight. And what a win for a guy who comes into this race 39th in points after DNFing three weeks ago, at Daytona. Talk about making the most of a bad situation. That's exactly what Kyle Matthews did, and what a victory for that team. Woo! Man, what a night here at Eldora. 2 amazing qualifying sessions, and then a really exciting race from start to finish. The Midsummer Classic here at Eldora has finally come to a close. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. Subscribe to become part of the crew today. Be sure to share this video with your friends. And we will see you guys next time as we're going to finish off this race weekend. The Mobile and Snickers Cup Series teams are down in Georgia at Atlanta Motor Speedway for their fourth race of the season. Be sure to tune in for that. And then after that, I believe we are heading to... Well, I know that the Mobile and Snickers cars, I believe, are heading over to Auto Club. I may be incorrect in that. And I believe we have a race up for Last of Us Light Series coming up, too. And I'm trying to remember where exactly that's at. I want to say Spartan. But I will give you guys that information, though, during the Mobile and Snickers Cup Series races to confirm that, because I do not have the schedule up in front of me at the current moment. So quite a shape of events here tonight. Kyle Matthews, 39th in points, wins the race. Sean Galligan, 41st in points, finishes second. And Dylan Poteet, who came in as the points leader, does not even start the main event of this evening's race. So talk about a point shakeup. I think you're about to see one, as here comes your official full finishing results. Overall point stands and rookie points heading into our next event, which I'm not exactly sure where it's at. I want to say Talladega, but I may be incorrect. So do not quote me on that. I will let you guys know the schedule as soon as I can. So thank you all so much for watching. We will see you next time as you've been watching a production of the NCRA Offline Racing at its best. Continues to flip. Now comes the rest. There is our caution.